Humans are unique in all sorts of ways. One of our fascinating differences comes from these pigment-producing cells called melanocytes, which control the color of our skin, our hair, and our eyes. Now, certain factors can cause these melanocytes to divide uncontrollably, leading to a cancer known as melanoma. There are many different types of melanomas depending on where these cells are found in our body. For example, when melanocytes in our eyes start to divide uncontrollably, this leads to a cancer known as uveal melanoma. Out of all the cancers that arise in our eyes, uveal melanoma is the most common type. The incidence rate of this cancer in Canada has been steadily increasing annually, and the highest incidence rate is right here in BC, with approximately 30 cases per year. So what happens in these patients is initially a gene mutation in the melanocytes will lead to tumor formation in the eye. But then later on, the cancer can also spread to other areas of the body. This is known as metastasis. One of the most common areas of metastasis is the liver, as shown in the illustration on the left. This usually occurs when melanocytes have only one copy of chromosome 3 rather than the normal two copies. As a result, patients with only one copy of chromosome 3 in their melanocytes tend to have a much lower survival time. Now, within chromosome 3 is a gene called BAP1, and this is frequently mutated in uveal melanoma patients who have liver metastasis. Now, BAP1 normally inhibits the growth of cancer cells. So naturally, the loss of either one or both copies of BAP1 should promote cancer formation. However, BAP1 loss on its own does not lead to uveal melanoma. But instead, it is an additional mutation in the BAP1 gene that causes the cancer to spread to the liver. As of yet, the reason behind why BAP1 mutations lead to liver metastasis has not been well established. In order to further understand this, our lab has created mouse models of uveal melanoma. Some of these mice have a deletion in the BAP1 gene that causes the cancer to spread from their eyes to their livers. And my project involves two parts. First, comparing the eye tumors to the liver tumors in the mice with a BAP1 deletion. And second, comparing the tumors in the mice with normal BAP1 to the tumors in the mice with BAP1 deletion. By doing so, I hope to determine the mechanism in which BAP1 mutations lead to liver metastasis. In Canada, approximately 50% of the people diagnosed by uveal melanoma will develop metastasis. As a result, I think that understanding the role of this BAP1 gene is an essential first step to identify potential targets for treatment and increase the survival time of the many patients impacted by this disease. Thank you.